Hello, this is Mark Laughlin with Ambidextral Gunfighter doing a review on the Borei Eagle pocket holster. This is a little promotional piece of material that comes with the holster along with the instructions that are included in the package on how to use it. Now, my first original carry for the LCP is this leather pocket holster, which is awesome. It's great, very well made, and you basically in your pocket you stick your hand down between the outside cover of the holster and grab the pistol and withdraw the weapon. Now the downside is that this is a little bit heavy. The weight of the LCP with this leather holster is 15 ounces. So the advantage of this Borei holster is, look at that tiny little thing. It's basically a trigger guard holster with a tab on it. And the LCP clicks right in, and there you have your pocket holster. It has the hook there to catch on the clothes so you can withdraw the weapon. Of course, you want to draw the weapon at an angle so that hook engages and yanks, so you're able to yank the pistol out of the holster. Now the weight of the pistol with this holster is 12.4 ounces, so you save 2.6 ounces by going with this holster. And that's not to mention the fact that it is less volume. It takes up less space, so it's more compact. It doesn't print as much as the thicker leather holster. Now the advantage of the leather holster is with this big thick leather back cover, while it does print more, it prints more like a book than a pistol. So there's that advantage for the leather holster. But I like saving weight. Size and weight's important, so that's why I've tried these Borei Eagle holsters. Now they make this not only for the LCP, but they also make it for the Kel-Tec PF9. And so in this case, now with this holster on a PF9, and I measure the weight of it, and we're running at 18.4 ounces. So basically, you're able to carry a PF9 instead of this LCP in the leather holster, just a couple more ounces, and you have a 9mm pistol and an additional round. So, and this does fit in the pocket nicely. Fits in my 5.11s front and rear just fine. Now, if you want to push the limits of the pocket holster idea, here we are with the Walther PPQ M1 Classic, which I consider the ambidextral pistol, and the same idea. Basically a trigger guard with a hook on it to help hold the holster in place while you withdraw the weapon. Now the Walther PPQ with a loaded mag and this holster weighs 32 ounces, so 2 pounds, and the holster makes up basically none of that weight, so to speak. So while this is not going to fit in most clothes, it does fit in the front pocket of my 5.11s, and it will fit in the back pocket, but the top of the slide does poke out the top of your pocket, or you can put it, of course, on your thigh. The pocket that's down on your thigh on your 5.11s. So, but still, it's a little bit heavy for pocket carry, but it can be done. So instructions recommend that you place your unloaded pistol in the holster first, what's covering the trigger guard, insert your magazine, rack the slide. If you've got a round chamber, you can eject the magazine because the magazine button is still exposed with this holster. Insert your next round to top off the magazine and reinsert it in the pistol, all while the trigger guard is covered. This works just fine with those pistols that have a button style magazine release. Now you can't do that on the Walther PPQ because when you put the holster on the PPQ, it is covering your magazine release. You're not able to actually release the magazine while it is in the holster, which I regard actually as a good thing because that means you will not have an accidental ejection of your magazine in your pocket. Or if you bump something if this pistol is in your pocket and then you sit on something or bump something, that magazine release may be engaged and depressed, and you may end up with your magazine loosely sitting in your pistol. And so that when you come to pull it out, one, that magazine may get in the way of you actually getting it out of your pocket, or you're only going to have one shot and have to deal with reseating the magazine. So anyway, it's just something to keep in mind. I think in general, for most people, you won't have a problem with a magazine release, especially if you do as per my recommendation and you work from the left side. That is, you use your holster in your left pocket, whether it's the front pocket or rear pocket, and then you present the weapon using your left hand. Now, if you've seen my video series, Caring for Self-Defense, you understand why I recommend, one, being ambidextrous, and then two, for initial presentation, using the left hand. Why is that? There's several reasons. One is that you're in a fight, you may be punching, shoving, or fighting off an aggressor, or even using a knife, and typically you're going to do better hand fighting with your right hand for most people. And so you want to save your fight with your punch with your right hand, and then back up and get distance so you can draw your pistol with your left hand. Now the other thing is that you can also ride a motorcycle and still shoot your pistol, because on a motorcycle you have the throttle and front brake on the right hand side, and on a motorcycle you have to maintain contact with those two controls to actually drive a motorcycle. You can't really run a motorcycle left-handed. You have to do that right-handed because of the throttle. So that means while riding a motorcycle with your right hand, you can actually pull a pistol and engage targets while riding a motorcycle. Now the other thing is I recommend left-handed, and this is kind of going back to my Caring for Self-Defense series, just to reiterate, is that, for example, as a law enforcement officer, if you are having to deal with a high-risk traffic stop and you're exiting your vehicle, left-handed means as you're exiting your vehicle, you have the cover of the door and with your pistol on the target. And then if you're approaching a vehicle that's high risk, having your weapon on your left side and if you need to, presenting it with your left hand, you get a better angle on the driver in the vehicle with your left hand than you do your right hand. And so you're able to make actual better use of cover of the vehicle that you're approaching and be more behind the driver as you approach him, but yet have an angle to deal with a threat. So that's just a few of the reasons that I recommend left-handed deployment or left-handed holstering and left-handed presentation of the pistol. And if you do it that way, that means the magazine button on push-button guns will be on the outside of your pocket and not pressing up against your body and perhaps getting activated. They still could, if you hit something in the environment, you could still push that button by accident. So that's the advantage of the PPQ and the paddle-style mag release, is that when you have a holster, those paddle magazine releases are not only the trigger covered, but your magazine release is covered as well. But that does mean you have to put the holster on, and if you're running around in the chamber, you want to make sure you put that holster on in a way that you're not going to depress that trigger. So in sum, the Barai Eagle, a great way to pocket carry. It's lightweight and takes up less space, but the real advantage is convenience. The pocket carry style, while it's not the best for when it comes time to need to withdraw your weapon, it's going to be better. It's more tactically sound to draw from either the appendix carry or inside or outside the waistband. Pocket carry is just not quite as quick to get your weapon out. But it is easy to make sure you have a weapon with you. And that's kind of the whole point. You see in a lot of these mass shooting situations where people are expressing regret, saying, "Oh, I can't believe it, here I am, and I left my gun at home." And you hear that over and over, regrets that they did not have a weapon with them during a mass shooting. And the reasons that they did not have a weapon are two. One, the pistol was too big or too heavy to carry on a daily basis. It's basically a nightstand gun. It's not really a concealed carry weapon that you're going to carry every day because it's too heavy. Size and weight, size and weight, size and weight. The other thing is that, okay, even if you do have one of the modern compact Mini 9s like the SIG P365 or a PF9 or even an LCP, the putting on a conventional holster is a hassle. Whether it's tucking inside the waistband, inside your belt, it takes time. It's a hassle. If it's outside the waistband, still you got to clip it on your belt. Shoulder holster, it's still you got to don a whole harness just to carry your weapon. And whereas pocket carry with a holster like this, it is as simple as putting your wallet in your pants. If you can remember to bring your wallet to the store, then you can remember to bring your pistol. It's Mark Laughlin with Ambidextral Gunfighter, www.ambgun.com. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe.